you know, it's always those losses that you could have won, that you should have won, that always hurt the most. And yeah, I know, on paper, it's gonna say that the Steelers beat the Eagles. But let's say it all together, kids. The Eagles beat themselves. I mean, that's it. That's just the plain truth of it. You can't go on the road and play a good team, turn the ball over in the red zone, not get any sacks on defense, not cause any turnovers, and expect to win. But then again, maybe I'm looking at it through rose-colored glasses, and I know I am, so shut up, but follow me on this one. They beat the Giants, defending Super Bowl champions. They beat the Ravens. They were in the AFC Championship game last year, and they came this close to beating the Steelers. That's another playoff team from last year. If Mike doesn't fumble into the end zone, or the defense stops him on the last drive of the game, we're singing a whole different tune this week. Say what you want, but the Eagles are playing some pretty good teams, pretty tough, and they got a winning record. Let's quit turning the ball over and we should be on our way, right? Speaking of pretty good teams, welcome back to Philadelphia to the Detroit Lions. Oh, the Detroit Lions. But you know what scares me about this team? Eh. Megatron. You know who I'm talking about, Calvin Johnson, the wide receiver named after the bad guy in the Transformers movie. But you know what, Detroit? We got some Transformers of our own in Philadelphia. What? You never heard of Shadytron, the all-purpose robot that can stop on a dime but rev it up to 100 miles an hour in a flash? No? Well, how about Jenkins Dozer, all right? Half man, half bulldozer plowing through offensive lines. How about Silicon, built like a tank, takes a licking but keeps on ticking. And of course, you cannot forget about their fearless leader, dressed in all black, Andy Bot. Time's yours. Yeah, I know. I gotta work on the names. Megatron sounds a lot cooler. So here is how the Philadelphia Eagles beat the Detroit Lions. Key to victory number one. You gotta get off to a faster start. Man, I know most people are concerned with the Eagles being ranked 31st, that's second to last, in overall points.
Well, that sucks.
But you know what concerns me even more than that? In five games, five, the Eagles have only scored 24 points going into halftime. 24. What are you waiting for? An invitation to the end zone? The party's in the end zone. Go there. Come on in, boys. The water's fine. What is that? Do you guys like playing from behind? Seriously, the Eagles are averaging between a field goal and a touchdown going into halftime. What? Newsflash. You're not going to win like that. Not with an offense that's designed to get it down the field and get on the board quickly. Not with a defense that's designed to get after the quarterback and be aggressive because they know they got points on the board. You gotta score, and you gotta do it early. Set a tempo, set a tone to the game. I'm not worried about the overall points. They will come. You just gotta put it in the end zone, preferably before halftime. Key to victory number two, take away the passing attack of the Lions. Which is easier said than done, considering the whole Stafford-Johnson pedigree thing. But if you really want to crack open that silver-tipped faux hawk Schwartzy's got going on and screw with that guy's head, take away the pass. Because they sure as hell ain't going to beat you with the run. They're 24th in the league in rushing, all right? They're averaging 91 yards per game. Ain't going to beat you like that. But they do have the second-ranked passing attack, all right? 322 yards per game through the air, and they will beat you like that. I'm calling it, and I'm calling it right now. If Calvin Johnson has anything less than like 75 yards receiving, birds win. I'm calling it. Key to victory number three, the pass rush. Hey, fellas, it's been a while. What you been up to? Last time the Eagles had a sack on a quarterback, his name was Kevin Cobb. I know Pittsburgh was doing a lot of like max protection, all right? But come on, guys. Get there. Two games without a sack. Isn't half our roster like defensive linemen? What the hell? Not one of yous can get there? And really, the pass rush is a trickle-down effect on everything else. You don't get the pass rush, you're not going to get the turnovers. You don't get the pass rush, you're not going to get the field position. You don't get the pass rush, you're not going to get the win.
First, you get the pass rush, all right? When you get the pass rush, then you get the turnovers, all right? When you get the turnovers, then you get the field position, all right? When you get the field position, then you get the win. Alright, man.
So here it is, EROCK's Week 6 prediction. The Eagles have been hanging around with some pretty tough teams. And despite being 1-3, the Detroit Lions are a tough team. But the Lions, last time you visited Lincoln Financial Field, we creamed you 56-21 while wearing canary yellow. If you stare at those uniforms for too long, you will get a migraine. Imagine what we're gonna do to them wearing midnight green. That's right. Eagles win 28-24. Before we get to Facebook Friday, you know I'm pushing for it. You know I need your help. The Dunkin Donuts, Philly's coolest fan contest, all right? Right now I am currently in third place. That is effing unacceptable. I am begging you guys, all right? I provided the link below. Go to their Facebook page. Give them the old like-a-roo. Go to the contest tab, look up EROCK, vote for EROCK, all right? Daddy needs to win this thing. Speaking of winning shit, congratulations, Jason White, for winning last week's Facebook Friday. This week's Facebook Friday prize will be a custom 8x10 signed by Eagles wide receiver DeSean Jackson. And you can thank our friends at PhiladelphiaEagles.com for that one. Real quick shout out to the Mole and Mirror Show. I provided the link to their page below. Also, Trevor Neal, who I met tailgating at the last game. And if you're going to the Lions game, if you're tailgating, if you're drinking beers, if you're flipping burgers, keep an eye out for your boy EROCK and the PhiladelphiaEagles.com crew. We're going to be meandering around the parking lots asking fans their opinions about the game. Until next time, let's go Birds, and I will see you next week.